HTC Vive Flow is a powerful VR device that can cure depression, help you be a better parent, and make your kids disappear while you meditate or hang out in a virtual lo-fi bar. Wait, what? The recent HTC announcement of the new VR headset left me puzzled. On the one hand, I'm quite happy that HTC is re-entering the consumer market again after focusing on business models lately. But on the other hand, what exactly did they just release? Being the king of teasers, HTC teased their new Vive Flow device for weeks, and naturally we all hoped for an amazing new standalone VR headset, but what we've got is this sunglassy-looking headset with the main purpose to promote mental health and not at all gaming. That's right, Vive Flow is not the headset for gamers, but rather for busy moms? Surely you can play some meditative games like Space Slurpees and Trip, but couldn't we already do that with Quest? Okay, let me start again, from the very beginning. What is HTC Vive Flow? During the live-streamed launch event, we've learned that the central focus of Vive Flow is increasing productivity and promoting self-care by helping you relax with various meditative VR apps, ASMR, and relaxing games. You can also connect it to your phone and stream on a cinema-sized screen. Essentially, Vive Flow is focusing on promoting mental health and mindfulness, and also adds a virtual home theater that can fit inside your pocket. That doesn't sound bad, but is it really enough? After all, the headset comes with a high price tag of $499, which is $200 more expensive than the 128GB model of Oculus Quest 2. So what exactly does Vive Flow offer that can possibly justify this price difference? That is a good question, and one that I find really difficult to answer. For one, Vive Flow is very compact and lightweight. It is promoted as being lighter than some cell phones, about 190 grams. I don't know if that's light enough to be sitting on your face comfortably because I didn't have the chance to try it, but yeah, they make it look like sunglasses rather than the headset, so obviously it's going to be a little bit more front heavy. And then Vive Flow gives and Vive Flow takes. Let's look at the lenses. The lenses themselves have individual diopter adjustment dials, which are great for people who wear glasses since they won't need them in VR. But at the same time, they don't have an IPD adjustment, which is really bad for, well, all people. If you can't set the IPD according to the distance between your pupils, then how on earth are you going to have a comfortable immersive experience? We can only hope that this sweet spot of Vive Flow could accommodate most people's IPDs. This is what HTC promises. But I think that my main issue with this headset is the target audience. During the presentation, they talked a lot about self-care, mental health, fighting stress of everyday lives, and finding inner peace. They also mentioned mothers that could find some peace and quiet in VR while meditating or whatever they're doing in VR, but I personally have a hard time imagining a mother who is not a gamer and not into VR, and quite frankly might not even have time for some more regular routine things like getting a regular haircut, getting manicure even, especially with really little kids, to spend $500 on a device that she has never tried before and doesn't even know if it's actually going to help her relax. And how can you really isolate yourself in VR relaxing while you have a little kid in the house? I emphasize that these are VR glasses and not AR glasses, and the pass-through mode is not available in Vive Flow. This whole pitch, this idea, seems like it has a lot of holes. And if it was really an experimental device designed to test the waters in the populations that are not used to VR and gaming in general, and then the price would need to reflect that. And or maximum $200 would have been marginal to sway some people to try this VR version of a Calm app. But $499? I'm having a really hard time wrapping my head around the idea of busy people who are stressed out with the work and are trying to find the balance to invest in a VR device that offers less than a device which costs almost half the price. And finally, while you unlock lots of media functionality by connecting Vive Flow to a smartphone, the key problem here is that it doesn't work with Apple devices. So if you've got an iPhone, you can't enjoy the headset's 6 degrees of freedom. Basically, connecting to an Android phone will make it work like a laser pointer in your headset. But if you don't have one, then what? This is all very strange, and while I think that HTC's goals of tackling the issues of emotional and mental well-being are admirable, I, for one, think that these immersive glasses are lacking in probably the most important aspect – accessibility, both financial and technical. $500 is an acceptable price for VR enthusiasts, but not for busy moms or stressed-out non-gamers, simply because there's just so many cheaper and easier and more familiar ways to relax. And the limitation to only Android phone users is, well, it's just silly for a device of this price. Friends, these are my thoughts on Vive Flow. Don't get me wrong, I'm still excited that HTC is targeting consumer market again, but I think I will speak for many VR enthusiasts out there when I say we expected something very different. Please let me know what you think about Vive Flow in your comments. I'm really curious to see what you guys think about. The good news is that this and next year are expected to be quite rich in the new VR announcements. I will soon be reporting on the new mixed reality headset Lynx. Its Kickstarter campaign has started last week and it's already surpassed its goal. Hopefully very soon we will hear about the new headsets from Apple, Vario, PlayStation VR and of course Oculus. Remember to subscribe to Disco VR and follow me on social media for more behind the scenes look on my channel. I greatly appreciate your support. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay safe, and as always, happy gaming!